amazing. There's a hole that goes in there. And there's another hole that goes up from here. This is a big tree. Beautiful tree. Structure. Some more structure in here. Structure in right there. Another hole that goes up and in. This is cool. It's like a teepee type one. Look at that. This tree is used a lot. You can see the bark peeled off it, all the way up it. It's gotta be a seat spot right here. That's so cool. The broke off ones are lineup points. Maybe like that. That is so neat. Look at this. Look at this two stick teepee X, I call them. They look like a teepee out of two trees or two sticks. But if you see that, I think that's like one of their markers for where they are, you know. Mind blown. I see the little X right underneath. It's small. Makes the asterisk with that other one. Look at that. They even X'd that. Wow. Right back behind. Man. Look at the ground structure and off that. My goodness. Here's a seat. See those bowled out, and that's right around there. See what else we can find. Here's another seat right there. Here's your Trident Type 1 right there. Structured. Holy moly. I was skirted by something up there. Probably a. I have that happen a lot with like timberwolves or coyotes or deer. Like they'll come in and check me out. Usually a deer, you know, this time here it's a buck that'll come in to see if it's a doe because they're in the rut this time of year. Right, you know, right along all the structure in there and all this, there's a trail, a really used trail. See how they brought all three of those together right there? This actually goes down, there's a lake right over there, middle of nowhere lake, but then it's kind of like a big valley, probably a swamp. Amazing. had a, I wish I would have had my video on, but what I heard skirting me and checking me out was a young buck. And he actually came probably from here to that birch tree away from me. Till I realized I wasn't a doe. Till he realized. So then he ran and I was like, hey buddy, what's up? And he stops and looks at me and then runs again. What a beautiful evening. There's a teepee structure. There's actually there's 1, 2, 3, 4 of them that come into that. There are some big timber tracks from early this morning, I think, because we had snow. A little bit of snow. They're just covered up, so. They're Timberwolves. I've come, up to Timberwolves. Not purposely. I rounded a corner on it. Small river. The river throws over and saves. So I was walking that back to my truck and come around the corner, and here comes a Timberwolf around the other way. But, yeah. They all saw me, and I scared the crap out of him more than he scared me. I was a little nervous. But, most everything in the woods will leave you alone. They're afraid of people. Not always. There's rare cases, of course. There's one north of here where I live, probably about 40 miles north. Where this kid fell asleep. They were camping at a campground. And, this campground's out in the boonies, but actually up by, Winnie Lake, and he fell asleep out by the fire in a chair. He woke up to a timber wolf, like latched onto his head with his jaws, and Percy freaked out, and he was fine. I think he had stitches and stuff, but the timber wolf took off, and the only reason the timber wolf did that was because its jaw was injured. It probably got shot by a human or something of that sort, but it was having a hard time getting food and it was starving. So that was the only reason. Well, I'm back at my truck. Bye, guys.